In today's video, I'm sharing 10 winter fashion trends that everyone else may like, but I don't. And for that reason, I think we need to avoid them. Hi, I'm Leonie and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, hello, I'm really pleased that you found me. I post new fashion videos on my channel every single week. And if you like this one, maybe consider subscribing. But today we're talking winter fashion trends, and in particular, the trends that I think are not worth wasting our money on. There are some amazing fashion trends out there, and there are some that just aren't going to cut it. Now, I know that these videos are really divisive because you are either in total agreement with what I say, or you may absolutely love some of these trends, and that is okay. Fashion is subjective and there is no right and wrong after all. But these are the trends that I really don't think are worth us wasting our hard-earned money on. But if you disagree, as always, please tell me in the comments below. But let's get on with these top 10 trends to avoid. And at this point, I'd just like to say a very big thank you to the team at Skillshare for sponsoring today's episode. I love working with brands that I have a real personal connection to, and Skillshare is one of those brands. I've been working with them for a number of years now, and if you haven't heard of Skillshare before, which would be surprising, but if you haven't, they're an amazing online learning community, and I've taken a number of Skillshare courses. They are super easy video courses from people who are absolute experts in their field, and Skillshare offers courses on every single thing imaginable. There's something for everyone, whether you want to do a business course, or you just want to learn how to paint or draw or make YouTube videos, whatever it may be, there is a course for you. I've just finished a really fun course on Skillshare, and it was basically teaching me how to do what I call upmarket doodling. The course is by a woman called Mel Rye, and she just kind of shows you how fun and easy it is to kind of doodle and have fun just drawing kind of patterns and shapes so you can lose your mind and just relax. And I've really, really loved that. I've got a couple of ideas of some kind of doodle style artworks that I'd like to create, because I'm not at all good when it comes to drawing or painting. I just can't draw to save myself. But doodling is another thing altogether, and I'm really enjoying how chilled and relaxed it makes me feel. But there really is a Skillshare course for everyone, and there are no ads in any of the courses. You can take and follow the course at your own speed, so you can dip in and out of the course whenever you have time, which I particularly love as well. And the team at Skillshare have kindly given me a very special offer for you guys today. So for the first 1,000 people to use the link in my description box below, you will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. So that's a really cool offer. So if you would like to upskill, learn something new, do what I do and just get lost in a fun new hobby, then definitely check out Skillshare and use that link down below to take advantage of your free trial. Okay, the first trend that I am saying is a big no-no in my mind is the big trend this season for wearing catsuits and jumpsuits. Now, these types of pieces are tricky enough to wear in summer, but in winter, it just kind of takes them to a whole new level. Obviously, when you go to the bathroom wearing any kind of full-piece jumpsuit, overalls, bodysuit type kind of thing, it's really, really tricky. Also, the kind of look that we're seeing this winter for jumpsuits and catsuits is really form-fitting. And I don't know about you guys, but for me, in winter is when I quite like to kind of relax and not be so conscious of everything I eat and my size, and I just like a bit of comfort. And in my mind, this kind of body-hugging, form-fitting catsuit, jumpsuit, just there's no leeway there at all. So for that reason, it gets a big thumbs down from me. But I'd love to know what you guys think. Are you into this look or not? Let me know in the comments below. The other trend that's really gaining momentum for winter is sheer fabrics. Now, I just can't really see the sense in this unless you're kind of wanting to wear it layered over some thick wool knits just to keep you warm. Maybe I'm getting old, maybe I'm just getting too practical, but any kind of really sheer pieces just don't work when it comes to winter, especially if you live in a really cold climate. The amount of time and effort that you would have to put into styling these pieces and making them weather appropriate is, in my mind, just not worth the effort. So I'm kind of surprised that designers have continued down that path of sheer fashion pieces for winter. They have been here for fall, but they're gaining momentum for winter. And they're not practical. It makes getting dressed extra tricky, so for that reason they're a no from me. The next trend that I'm struggling to see the sense of for winter is cutouts. Now, cutouts, as we know, were really on trend and quite popular for spring summer, and that seems to have just continued on. I've seen them here for fall. There are lots of pieces available at the moment with cutouts, whether they're cutouts in dresses or tops, but that trend is gaining momentum for winter, and I just don't think it's very practical. It's not particularly sensible. Again, if you live in a really cold climate, it's not an easy piece to incorporate into an outfit. So cutouts just don't make a whole lot of sense for me when it comes to winter dressing. Now, I know that a lot of us have been hibernating for the last year, and designers obviously know that we are well and truly over being locked down in our homes, but they seem to have almost gone to an extreme, and there's this real trend that I'm kind of calling space age. It's sort of metallics and sequins and just kind of almost space age sci-fi sort of shapes and silhouettes as well. And I just think, again, it's not going to stand the test of time. If you love sequins and sparkles, maybe you'll be able to find a piece this season that is going to be a piece that you can wear all year round. But these types of pieces just don't work easily into winter wardrobes. And for that reason, I'm saying another big no to space age dressing. And speaking of designers trying to design for our day-to-day lives, another trend that I am so not here for is super, super long sleeves. Now, I'm almost 6 foot tall and I've always struggled to find the length in sleeves and pants. But what's happened this season is they have got extra, extra long. And maybe designers were thinking that we were using our sleeves to open doors and not wanting to touch anything in these COVID times, but they've kind of taken this trend to an extreme. And even for someone like me that has extra long limbs, these sleeve lengths are even way too long for me. So they're tricky to style, they're impractical, they're just not necessary, and for that reason they get a no from me. Now, if you've been following me here for a while, you'll know that I'm all about loungewear, and I love really comfy, cool sweatsuits and gorgeous loungewear pieces to relax in at home. But there is one piece that seems to be gaining momentum that I just don't think is very practical, and that is cable knit pants. Now, these are not just fine knitted pants, but these are actually knit pants, as you would imagine a knitted sweater. And the reason that they get a no from me is they're the kind of piece that looks good when it's worn on a model or when it's styled in a gorgeous magazine shoot, but the practicality again isn't there. So these pieces, once you wear them a couple of times, they're going to get knees in them, they're going to stretch out of shape, and they, in my mind, run the risk of looking really sloppy really fast. So for that reason, I am not here for these cable knit, thickly woven knitted lounge pants. Now, this one may be a little bit contentious, but minis are really big. That is the skirt length for winter. And it may be why we've seen a return to lots of patterned and fun, colorful tights, because obviously we can't wear minis in the winter without covering our legs up with lovely tights or knee-high boots. But minis have returned, and for the fact that they are just, they're cold, and you do need to think about other elements like your tights and your legs and be aware of more items to kind of create an outfit, apart from the fact that they're just not going to be cozy and keep you warm. And I sort of feel like we've done the whole mini 70s style trend. So I'm kind of not here for the trend as a whole. And because, again, it's not so practical. I know I'm sounding like someone's grandmother here, but I do think fashion has to be practical, especially if you're going to spend your hard-earned money on it. If you are just after a one-season wonder, that's a different story. But if you want to buy well, or buy less and buy well, then I would suggest not spending your hard-earned cash on mini skirts. Now, I'm blaming the big designers like Chanel, Fendi, Versace, who all sent models down their runway wearing this trend, and the high street labels have followed suit. So that's the trend for logo mania. Now, I know that logos have been sort of slipping back in slowly but surely in the last couple of seasons, but full logo prints seem to be back. And in my mind, it's just a bit too much, especially if you're going to buy high street labels where it's almost like a fake logo. It's kind of, some of them are looking a bit Fendi-ish or a little bit Chanel-like, but they're not. So I'm not into copies, I'm not into dupes of designer logos, and I suppose that's what this one feels like. It almost feels like it's kind of wanting to be wearing Chanel or Fendi or whatever it may be, but not. And I don't know, I kind of think you either spend the big money on those labels or you don't, and anything else just kind of becomes a little bit of a poor cousin. But that's just me. What do you guys think of logos and logo prints and patterns on dresses and skirts and pants? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below, but they're not for me. Now, we all know that skinny jeans are out, and I am not mad about that, to be honest. But designers have almost taken things a little bit too far in my mind. I love kind of boyfriend style, slightly baggy, oversized pants, but jeans seem to be extra baggy and extra slouchy. And again, I think this trend can work really well when it's in a professional photo shoot or on the runway or on a waif-like model, but it's really hard to make this look chic and sophisticated when you've got so much fabric, especially denim, because it's fairly unforgiving, it's fairly stiff. So I just think these kind of slouchy denim jeans and pants almost are too frumpy for my liking. I think there is a middle ground there, and extra slouchy is not it. Now, every winter we seem to be seeing a kind of a crafty DIY home style sort of boho type trend that emerges, and this winter it is back as well. And for some reason, I don't know whether it's a personal like dislike thing, it's a taste thing, but I just have never really been here for that look. I definitely think that, again, it can look a little bit too homespun, or dare I say kind of homeless looking. I just think it can go horribly wrong unless you style it really well. And I suppose for that reason, that's one of the reasons why I sort of pull back from pushing a trend like this, because it has that potential to go one way really fast, and that's not really a fashion way. I feel like I'm slightly getting tongue-tied talking about this one, but I do think that real kind of patchworky boho style is a difficult one to pull off really well, and for that reason it's made it on this list. Anyway, that's it from me today. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, I'd love you to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.